Hey guys, it's Marlene. In this video, we're going to talk about focusing your videos. I've had a few questions recently about this topic. And the biggest thing is, don't be afraid of it. Do your own tests and just figure it out, commit it to memory, and you'll be fine. The first thing you have to do when shooting video is to go into the menu under your video settings, continuous autofocus. Now, when you click into that menu, you have three choices. Mode 1, which continuous autofocus only works while recording video. Mode 2, continuous autofocus works all the time. And off. Now, when it's off, what you need to do is push your shutter button if the focus is attached to your shutter button, or your back button focus if the focus is attached to your back button focus, or by touching the back of the screen. Like this, so it will focus wherever you touch. Otherwise, it won't focus. So you actually have to activate the auto focus with a button. For most of my tests, I use mode 1. And when I'm shooting videos of myself, I always have it in mode 1. It seems to work fine. But mode 1 or mode 2 work great. And so does feature disabled. It's whatever you're comfortable with, but I suggest that you do some tests in each mode and in each autofocus mode to see the best combination for your workflow and your subject matter. Everybody is slightly different. Don't forget that. Just want to give a shout out to those of you who have been participating with me on my community tab on my YouTube channel. Now, if you haven't seen it yet, the community tab is where I can share photos, and I tend to do that in between videos. It's a way for me to stay connected with you, and I have some poll questions up there as well. And I really appreciate all of you who are participating with me there. Thank you so much. I love this community. You have no idea. You're focusing on me, right? Right? Can you see me? Can you see me? So that's how I shoot in my little studio here. I don't have a camera operator. I just work alone. And I currently have the camera on autofocus single shot, custom multi with a big blob in the middle to focus. And it's that easy. But let me show you another one. This is one area, human detection. And I think I'm a human. Anyway, one area, human detection. That's how that works. Just set it up in the back of the camera. Same deal. Autofocus single shot. Tried pinpoint. Not sure if it'll work. I haven't actually tried pinpoint, pointing the camera at myself. But I do use pinpoint for photographing birds, especially the smaller birds. Those eagle photos I took about a week and a half ago, those were shot with pinpoint focus. Some of the smaller birds are shot with pinpoint focus because I just find it's more accurate. I like to focus on the eyes. Because I was shooting at such a steep angle, the animal focus didn't work that well because, like, you have this eagle here, let's say, and if I was at such a steep angle that the eyes were at a different focus distance than the bottom tail feathers. So I found that pinpoint was easier just to focus right on the eyeball. Okay, this is a 225 area focus, and I've got like quite a large area to grab focus from. I mean, it's not a very complicated setup here. There's me in a plain background, not a lot in the way. See if it'll see my hand. I'm not sure because my hand doesn't have much light on it. Now, one thing I didn't test here was tracking. I have used tracking with birds in flight, so don't sweat it. You can do your own tracking test just like you did all the other tests. And this is the human detection setting, which is on the left side of the menu. So it's not one area human, it's just human detection. Also has the animal detection as well. So picked a really small area actually, and I can see that it's going like right around where my glasses are. So hopefully it found me. If this video is helping you with your autofocus for video, please consider buying me a coffee. The link for that is in the video description below. Thank you very much. A couple of other settings you can look into are your focus settings. So that would be on page 1 of 8. and go to the AFAE lock button and you can set it up. Now this is this button right here. This is what we call sometimes the back button focus. And you can set it up for autofocus lock, or you could do AF near or AF far. Now you can also set autofocus near and autofocus far on the buttons on the front of the camera, and those are placed in a handy spot. I've made a video about near and far, but what that means is that when you press it, it will bias to the front of the frame. If it's on the far, it will bias to the rear of the frame. And this is handy when shooting birds through branches. And that's what happened here in the case of the eagles. But I like my back button focus just to be set on AF lock. I find, especially with pinpoint, that that is a good combination. So I use the two buttons on the front of the camera and the back button focus to lock in. And on some of my video clips, you're going to see, like, if it didn't find focus automatically, that I'm pushing one of those buttons and it's like finding it. So that's another tip. I definitely would advise you setting those up. Now with my eagle videos, it was really cold and windy, so I found it super hard to hold the camera still. So yeah, if you're shooting a lot of animal videos, you probably want a monopod or a tripod. It was too cold to carry a lot of gear that day. I basically had hand warmers on and one lens. I didn't change anything because, holy cow, I did not want to make my hands bare for very long. The bottom line with all of my videos and the testing and things like that is you've got to get out there and actually practice. You can't just watch a video and set it up and say, oh, it doesn't work. And like, it's taken me a long time to kind of hone my techniques. I spent basically 2021 photographing birds. Once I got my long lens, I was like right into birding. Thanks to my mom who found those initial owls on her morning walk one day. So you've got to spend the time, you've got to do the work in order to get your photos to where you want them to be. So don't give up, just keep practicing. Some of you did have a few questions about f-stops and shutter speeds that I use for video. I do have a video about that, so I will link that in the video description below. But don't tell anybody. You know, for those eagle videos, I just pushed the little red button on top because I didn't want to change any settings. I just like was shooting photos and, you know what? Let's take a couple of video clips while we're here. I don't sweat it too much, guys. I just don't. Leave that video on program mode if you're going to do that and don't worry about a thing. Now, of course, in the studio here, I'm shooting manual video mode. Let me see. What are my settings? f4.5, 1/125th of a second, and it looks like ISO 400. So there's my settings for this particular setup. Now this video was about focusing your video clips. However, all of these techniques work exactly the same when taking photos.